Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach Java inventory management system. This is for the movie ticket inventory management system. So let me see the demo. This is the movie category, price and ticket ID. Here if you ask the ticket for ODC, click on this one. It asks the quantity, how many people need for ODC. So if you enter the quantity as 3, it will be calculate the one person price will be 30. It calculates the 3-person price over here. If you want the balcony, it asks only 1 people, box 2 people, super balcony 4 people. Here the relevant price will be calculated. Very simple. This is a total, final total will be displayed over here. How to make this system step by step will teach. Right, first go to the file, new project, Java application, next movie inventory. Here if it is click on this one, please uncheck it, click finish. Now your project has been created with the name of this one. Here default package, you have to expand the source package. There will be the package called default package. Select on this one, new. Here we have a JFrame form. Here I have movie ticket. Press it. Right, this is your frame. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to make the heading. So get the label and drag on this. Here first I'm going to name the label movie ticketing system using Java. Select this one, properties, click on this one, with bold. I want to make little bit bigger, so I need to ask 36 will be enough. Right, that's it. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to do the another stuff is, I'm going to drag one panel over here. Right, simple panel. Yeah, right click, properties, border. We have to give the border style at least. How do we drag to J tables? So here we have the J table, the tables. Just drag them, arrange them. But you need to arrange them. Right. So here the same table. I just right click, table content, columns. First one should be the ticket ID, ticket name, price. We need only prefix. Right. This one need, we have to get rid of this one. So here what I'm going to, we have to assign some values over here. We have to put some values over here. Okay. So here what I'm going to see, we have to put it here as but add some values to these columns, right? So go to the properties, the models, default values. So you have to enter some values. One, ticket ID, this one should be the bulk ODC, price 30. Ticket ID to me, it is a balcony. To me, super balcony. Fourth one will be box. 250. Click OK. Right, simple. Okay, very simple. Now first what I'm going to see, you have to select this one. Control C to copy, Control V to paste and get another copy. We have to align it the next to this J table. So click on this one. These values I no needed. So right click, table content, rows, These all the rows I'm going to remove it. I don't need this one here. Right. So here we have to write here simply. We have to add another additional two columns. Those are quantity and total. So how to add those? Go to the table content, rows, columns. Insert another columns, quantity, total. Close it. Right. Right. Now what I'm going to do is I need a total price. So drag one label total. Select this one properties. This one font bold 24. Right. So here we drag one text field. Right click. Edit text, backspace to remove the existing text. Select this one again. We have to increase the font size little bit bigger. Font bold little bit bigger, like this. Simple, very simple, very simple. Now let's what I'm going to do is here. All the design we will complete it according this way simply. So let's run and check. Before run it, select this one, right click, properties, code, generate center. After that, what I am going to go to the source, we have to make another thing is, this is very essential stuff, control F, press control F, it will be the fine text box will be there. The UI design, you just type on UI, you have to change this one metal, it's a metal type. Run and check. This is the actual feel, look and feel of Java. The actual feel, look and feel of Java. This framework, right? If you check this one, it displays the ticket information on this text box. At the eventually type the calculator, all the total will be here. So how to do the task? So let's do that. Here I already done it. Mouse left. First time what I am going to do is here, instead of writing code, it's so boring. Go to source. This is the class which name is ticket movie ticketing. This is the constructor of the class. After the constructor, we have created the new class which is a default table model. We have created the object as D. Okay, here we have to write without a spelling mistake. This is very essential. When you interact with the JTable, this is a model we have created and insert the data into the table, right? This is the thing we have, right? Otherwise, if you are not implemented this package, you can't add the data in the row, right? So this is very essential stuff, right? After that, what I'm going to do is here, we have to just this one. I just copy this one. Just copy this one, right? Here, let's click this one, right click, event, mouse click event. We have to mouse click event. So type this code. We have to type, I just explain it, you just copy and paste it here. I will be explaining it. This one txt build, you have to name this one as change variable, you have to name it as txt build. Because when you are named this one, why I change the name, change variable name, it will be help you to understand the text box name easily. Okay, right? So here we have created the name different. Okay. So first I am going to create the variable data type double sum. You have to put 0.0 because this is the final total will be calculated as a double type. After that, I already created the data table model above here. They create the object D equal. We have to cast it default table model table 2 means the selected data will be displayed on the JTable 2. So table to get model in selected index j table to set selected row. What is the meaning by this is when you select the particular row, the selected row data will be displayed here, right? So you have to write like this, right? After that we have created the variable id. This one should be the ticket name, price. Okay, id, what is the row you have selected, the particular row you have created three variables id, ticket name, price. The particular row means the j table model d value at selected index. This is a variable. The j table 2, it will be displayed here. When you have selected the j table, this one 2, what is the thing? It will be this was the name of j table 1 will be displayed on the j table 1. So here we have selected here j table 2. Okay, so selected index 0 mean it will be assigned to the id. 1 mean goes to the ticket name. 2 mean it will be assigned to the variable price. Okay, don't worry about what is the 0 position, 1 position mean. If the if you take the j table position, it always starting with the 0 position. Ticket id will be 1, ticket name will be 2, ticket price will be 3. That's how set the position of j table. Okay, very simple. It's look like an array always start with 0 position, the same as j table also. It is always starting from the 0 position. What is 0 position value getting? It's a ticket id is always getting the as a first position. Ticket name always getting as a first, ticket id always set as a 0 position. Ticket name set as a first position. Price set as a second position, right? So if you click on this particular row, the selected row record will be display on the table 1 j table, right? So that it will display. After that, if you enter all the price, when you click on the relevant column row, after that ask the quantity how many people you have to buy. So you have to enter the quantity, it will be display the input box. This is the code of this one. After that it calculate the price and quantity. It will be price into quantity, it assigns the total over here. After that date table model, it will be display the j table model here. After that, add the row, new object, id, p name, this p not ticket name, this one ticket name, price and quantity, all the things are calculated here, right? After that we have to write the loop. What is the purpose we are writing the loop is we have to calculate the final total over here, right? So here we already declare the variable sum equals sum plus double pass in table 1 get at int 1 fourth position mean j table 0, 1, 2, 3, 4th position. 0, 1, 2, 3, 3rd position, the total we have to calculate. What is the values of these columns, row by row? This all the row entered values are getting and calculated and display the final total over here. That's the thing, we have to loop it. How many records you are entered on the particular row of the total, it will be loop it and calculate the particular total and display the variable sum. Okay, get the final total and assign, we have to get it, put it here, it will be display on the txt build text box. Get the total and convert it to the double type. When you are execute the program and check, click on this and ask the quantity, click on the ask the quantity, click ask the quantity, final total will be displayed over here. Very simple. I hope you guys you understood things well. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.